Let's have a look at one example I brought with me. I have here two lamps, traditional light bulb and an LED retrofit lamp. This one exists for 125 years, and we have been producing it for billions a year because it fails after 1,000 hours. After 1 year, it breaks. But over those 125 years, it never got any more expensive. So can you imagine 125 years of inflation fully offset because we use very efficient, very dedicated, fast production systems to produce it? The LED lamp lasts for 30 years. You put it in your socket at home, you never have to replace it again. That means after 5 years approximately, there's no more demand for such LED light bulbs. So your manufacturing supply chain for this digital product looks totally different. And that's depicted here in this graph, schematically. Depending on the length of your product life cycle and the volume, the demand that is asked, for the light bulb you can invest in a lot of capex. But if you move to here, the amount of money you can invest is much less. And you need to go to more flexible supply chains and supply chains, production systems, where you have much better reuse of capex. The most extreme case, of course, is 3D printed shaver. The volume is one. It's unique, basically. And you need totally new technologies for that to produce it.